Valentino, and this is Gag. How y'all feeling? How are y'all feeling? We done made it through March, baby. Whew, this year kind of going by fast. It's not 2020, thank God. But it's really been prosperous, I guess. We getting a lot of good. It's a lot of bad, too, but I'm not going to focus on that. But what I will focus on, the fact is, I did not get to give you guys a Grammy special. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. Poor timing. I would get better. I'm 24. I'm young. I make mistakes. But I don't mind apologizing for you. But I will recap the Grammys for you real quick. So let's get it. So, I love a little backstory. Backstories matter. So, Tiffany Haddish, she won a Grammy. She was elated. She was so happy. She found out while she was shooting her NBC show with little kids. I forgot the name of it. But in the middle of her filming, they told her that she won a Grammy. She was too excited. She literally broke down and told the girls why, like, she was so happy. Because she said the last time it was won by a black woman was 1987 for Whoopi Goldberg. Whoopi Goldberg won it. And that was the last time. So she was excited to have won the Grammy for Best Comedy Record after all this time. And I'm proud of her for that. I love black excellence. I love a good tearjerker. And that was everything. So go Tiffany, girl. You got it. Hey, y'all. Tiffany been looking good lately. She done cut her hair off. She blonde. She wearing tight dress. She been looking good. Y'all better watch out for Tiffany. She done got with confidence. She became a baddie. Church folks somewhere, everywhere, all places. We're probably mad again. I don't know if you guys remember, I reported back a couple of months ago that Billboard named Kanye West the number one gospel artist of the year, of 2020. And everybody was going crazy. Whatever. So he just won the Grammy for the Best Contemporary Christian Music Album. So he's showing y'all that him and God, like, this. Like, Kanye West is doing so good right now, even in spite of the fact that his wife just filed for divorce. And I'm proud of him, because I know he suffers from a lot of mental health things, and so I just want him to take these moments and count them as a win, because a Grammy for Best Christian Contemporary Album from Kanye West is a win. That's a W. Let's shout out Megan Thee Stallion. Why? Because she has 3 Grammys now. Yep, not 1, not 2, but 3. She got the Best Rap Song and Best Rap Performance for Savage with Beyonce. No. I guess that's the song of 2020. Hey. But she also got Best New Artist. And I don't know how I feel about that, because I feel like other people in the category, aka Miss Doja Cat, had a way better 2020. And when I say way better, I mean as an artist being new, from the versatility being shown, just album being drops, just singles, just a performance. I'm not saying Megan is a one-trick pony, but she does not show the versatility that Doja Cat has shown us, and I know she's going to give us even more of later on. So that's why I just feel that Doja Cat should have won. But hey, guess what? I'm nobody. I'm somebody, just nobody to the Grammy Academy, so I didn't get the vote. So, Megan won. She's the best new artist. She has 3 Grammys. 2 more than Cardi B. And we're just gonna leave that at that. Miss Beyonce. Did y'all see this video? Like, I really love this video because it shows how Beyonce and Jay-Z was just snuck in. They just snuck in. They had been there all night. And then the camera man with his little shady self was like, get him real quick. But they looked so good. Beyonce had on her little tight Tina Turner dress. Jay-Z and his hair was doing whatever Jay-Z and his hair was doing. It was a good night. B won 4 Grammys. 4 Grammys that night, so which made her the woman with the most Grammys ever in history. That was cute. That's real cute. it's crazy that she got that accolade with Black Parade, with Black Parade being such a big song in 2020, especially with social injustices and everything. So it just shows that she can be black and win. She can be herself and win. And I'm just ready to see what she does next. Because it's like, at this point, what's she going to do? Give us a gospel album? If Kanye West can win, why can't she? They like her for real. And she don't put her Grammys in toilets and piss on them like him. So I think they probably would be happy to give her. I guess. But my favorite performance of tonight was Bruno Mars and Anderson .Paak, Supersonic, Leave the Door Open. Baby, when I tell you Bruno Mars is stuck in the 70s, and he okay with it. He said, I'ma stay in this decade. They like this decade. I pulled this decade off well. They paid me. Like, so he gonna be stuck in the 70s. And when I tell you that song, it's just so perfect. It's so, hey. It's just smooth. Like, the song is just everything from the right end to the melody. It's just so right. So I can't wait to hear their album. I know their album is gonna be amazing. And I can't wait for it. I can't wait. I have to, but I can't. Speaking of performances, we have to address Cardi B's performance. Why do we have to address it? Because it's hot tea. That's why. So we're gonna start off with she looked amazing. I liked her hair. I'm not used to her with short hair. So the hair was plucked right. It was on right. It was set right. It was, everything about it was right. And the color was just perfect. I was excited to see her get to perform choreography on a Grammy stage. You have to think about it. We've had female rappers before her that really all their Grammy performances are nothing but them and them not being their true 100 self because they wasn't allowed to. So I'm happy that they gave her the platform to be streaming who she was. I love the stripping on the strip pole. I love the twerking. I love the little lesbian scene her Megan did with the flip and flop and top and top. Like, I love all that. Like, it just shows that times are changing. But what I hate is when we break up this narrative of Cardi doing something and time is changing, that we feel like we have to put down anybody else that came before her. And I like to let people live in a moment. Let her live in her moment for what she is doing. Because some people before have done stuff she never can or will do. No shade, just hot tea. And we'll be back.
Back when my roots ain't watered down, growing like a baobab tree, all life on fertile ground. Ancestor put me on game, long time on gold chains, with my ocean energy, drip all on me. Uncle that she keep friend, hola, donuts, galas, sacha, not chapa, incense, yeah, pure ice, 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 bust down, bloody, bloody, bloody.
I'm only half a mile of town. If you want it, better get it right now. I just wanna have fun and enjoy the now. No strings, I just wanna dick you down. Okay, you got it. Yeah, you in control.
And you guys, we are back with Mr. Phoenix. Hey, how you doing?
What's up, child?
Yeah, like, when I asked him to come on the show, I was kind of excited. I was nervous because you was the first like artist I had on the show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you're the first artist.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, everybody that's been on here has been like producers or like socialites, but nobody, not an artist. So you're my first artist.
We love a first.
All right, so when the show syndicated and all that, you can always say you're
okay,
the first one.
Okay, I was the first one on there. Okay. Y'all need to know. And that's the gag.
Tell the world about you. Tell the world who Black Phoenix is.
Let me see. Well, I am a rapper, dancer, songwriter. I was born in St. Louis, Missouri. I was raised in Minnesota. And then I came here in Atlanta about August.
And what sparked that? What made you? I love to hear people move to Atlanta story because I'm born and raised here. So I love to hear why people came to Atlanta.
So actually, they gonna hate me because at first, I actually really didn't like Atlanta because it was just like the people was hard to adapt to. Like, they're so...
Was it the Atlanta people or the people that moved here like you did?
I don't know because I feel like I'm a good influence on Atlanta, okay? I bring Atlanta...
It's people that move here that make a bad name for the city. It be folks.
Yeah, that's true.
So...
I mean, that's true. I mean, because... I've noticed that, like, every time there's, like, some type of event, it's like there's so many fights that go on that weekend, uh-huh. And I'm like, oh,
yeah, okay, so I see.
So you gotta avoid that. You were born and raised
okay. in Atlanta.
Well, then I don't know. I don't meet a lot of people who were born and raised here, so I don't know what to tell y'all. But I just remember service when I first got here was like crazy. I know,
like crazy good or crazy bad?
Crazy bad. Like you would go.
And when you say customer service, so we talking about like stores like or restaurants.
It don't matter. You can go to a store. They act like you the problem that came in.
Nobody want to be at work.
But why you gotta take it out on me? You getting a check? I got a job too. So you gotta do your job.
I feel that.
But no, I think after, you know, just kind of being here for a little bit, you know, I've been here for like 8 months or so. I think that it's like I've been able to assimilate more to it now. So I think that now it's a lot better. Like I know how to navigate. I know what clubs to go to, what clubs not to go to. And I really like it. Like the opportunity, I got to meet you, you know, yeah, you know, different type of people. So I think it's all good.
So with the meeting me, it's because you just released not one, but two.
I did.
New singles.
I did.
Mine and All Night.
I was hoping to ask you, what's the two singles? But you got it. Okay, so he did his homework.
I like All Night better.
You did. You know, to be honest, I like All Night better too.
And that's okay, but that's not me trying to say you have to pick and choose. But they was released on the same day.
I did pick and choose.
They released on the same day, and they were on Valentine's Day weekend. Mm-hmm. The Valentine's Day S. They're both songs that kind of deal with you and a significant other.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, and I know significant others in Atlanta.
So actually, it's a story. No, who did I write that about? But no. I think it was inspired on taking vacations. Like, you know how you take a vacation and you be like, you know, I'm here for a good time, not a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I don't personally say that myself, but I was like, you know what, let me make a song for that type of situation.
Okay.
And so actually, because I am kind of more of a sappy type of person, I was like, okay, let me take that, and then I made All Night. So it's like, okay, they kind of fuck for the first time, whatever, like that was just a one night stand kind of thing. But they actually end up liking each other. So then that's how we got mine, because mine is more like, you know, I want to be with that person. We together. We've been doing this for a while now because it stemmed from that one night. And so I feel like that fits me more because I'm the type of person, like, even though I'm supposed to have a one night stand.
You're supposed to. So you're single.
I am. But it's like I'm supposed to, like, okay, you know, we supposed to just do a one-night stand, but my dumb ass always be trying to catch feelings and shit, so.
No, it's nothing wrong with that. Love.
It is
love,
definitely love. Wrong, especially in Atlanta.
But
definitely wrong.
In the hookup culture, yeah.
Wow, when the right man comes.
You're going to be ready. And you're going to be ready to love him. And that's all. You're going to be his.
That's it.
And you got to listen to his song, Mine.
And All Night.
All Night, y'all.
Both of them. At the same time. Put it in the playlist. All that. All that.
So, I feel like he cheated y'all because he gave you a whole list of everything he was when we started off. He said he was a songwriter.
Yeah.
He said he was a rapper.
Oh, and I didn't ever answer a question. I moved down here for music. Forgot to mention that.
Music. Okay.
Yeah, music. That's all.
Okay. So, he moved out. He's all that. But he didn't get to tell y'all that he was a twerker. He did not put that.
I thought that was a part of the dancing. Is dancing not twerking?
Why do I have to highlight that?
No,
because of me. People like me. Because I did take dance, ballet, jazz, tap. When people tell me they're dancing, I automatically take that.
Okay, but I'm a hip hop.
If somebody tells me they're a twerker, I'm like, oh, let me see, go.
But I dance hip hop though.
Okay.
But see,
I feel like twerking is not just hip hop. I feel like twerking is.
No, but I've done like. Do you know the Missy Elliott Cool Off Challenge?
Yeah.
I did that.
I saw it.
So then I danced. I did more than just twerk.
I know, but I feel like twerking should have been on the list. Like,
so it should be a subcategory.
Yeah.
That's petty.
Because you got to make sure they know you can do that. Like,
I'm going to ask the people. Y'all, if y'all think that y'all, you know, twerking should be its own subcategory, leave a comment wherever you see this, because I don't think it should be its own subcategory.
I feel like if you say you're a dancer, you're a dancer.
If you
can tap, you can ballet, you can jazz. Okay. But I feel like if you're a twerker, That's a whole nother thing.
I mean, I don't know.
Cardi B's not a dancer, but she's a twerker.
She did. I do like Cardi B though.
No, we like Cardi. She just went number one with Up.
Because if it's Up, it's Up. Actually, I'm gonna go do that challenge. My brother, he's actually gonna record it.
I'm glad you brought it up. I have this thing. Do you feel like challenges have their well or dry? Like they have like a run? Because I feel like it's number one, Up is number one. The challenge, the video, and everything's been out for like over a month. Like, is it too late to do it?
It definitely probably is too late for me to do it, but I think people would like for me to do it.
Okay, so you're giving the people what they want.
That's it.
That's good. That's an artist.
But I do like the dance though. I love Sean Bankhead. Like, honestly, I do want to work with Sean Bankhead. Like, he has.
Girl, I heard he expensive.
He probably should because he choreographed the Cool Off Challenge, and I ended up doing that one, like, and I think that was the last time I danced too. So every time I see his choreo, it makes me want to dance. And so I'm like, that's somebody who I would want to work for. His work ethic is crazy. So that's definitely somebody I would want to work
for. So who else in Atlanta would you like to work with?
I don't know. I feel like I'm open, like, as far as like local or just like,
we'll do local, like, and then we'll go mainstream. Let's do local first.
I don't know a lot of local Atlanta artists. Okay. I think, like, when I think of artists who are like within LGBT, because that's if I'm gonna do a collab, that's who I'm gonna do a collab with first, right, to be honest. But when I think of local people, I think of like Kodak Ken, I think of Kid Ken, I think of Deli Boy, I think of Dre Bay, I think of,
okay,
yeah, like they doing their own little thing, like,
dang, yeah, they, yeah, got their own little movement,
exactly.
And the link up was real between
all of them, to, yeah, be honest, because like they all kind of like
they interchangeable each
other. And that's what I want for like the older gay rappers. I think they're all young as shit, so it's,
yeah, they're
like,
19, 20, 23
and shit, so it's like, okay, that's cool for them, but I want that for like us, kind of thing. But
it was different. You gotta, yeah, and I'm gonna say it's different for the older, because at the time everybody was an innovator.
Yeah.
Everybody that's up there stand up there because none of them are the same. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying that these new kids aren't all the same. I'm not saying that.
No, they aren't.
I'm just saying that because
even the ones
different.
I mentioned are hella
different. It wasn't doing it because somebody was gonna see it.
Okay, but they work well together, and I feel like that's. I think for me it's bigger than just gay music, because I feel like artists a lot of the times are very competitive with each other, so then they don't want to work with each other, or they feel like, oh, I'm better than that person, so I don't want to work with them. And it's like, okay, but see the bigger picture. What kind of art would y'all create?
Great.
And that's what, yeah, I said, like, for example, like Kid Ken and Deli Boy, they have like a this chemistry that they
have. It's amazing.
And that's what I'm saying. That's what I want for the older gay rappers, but I feel like a lot of that, like, they just be hating on each other and stuff. And so, and to be honest, like, that's the part of the reason why I don't have any features. If you look at anything that I've ever done, I've never had any features on my own, like,
but are you projects ready for
them? Absolutely. And I welcome them because I like I said, like, I love people and I like growing together. And I feel like when you collab with somebody, as long as it's the right collab, right, not like, oh, because of clout or something like that, if y'all sound like meshes and it's a genuine like connection thing, then I feel like y'all should do it.
So I'm gonna ask you this: out of the older gay rappers, which, if you got to choose any of them, which one would you do a song with?
I would say 7D. Do y'all know 7D?
Yes, I know. Oh, okay. I don't consider him an older gay rapper.
7 Deep is like the same same age as like me, around, I think. I'm 26.
Okay.
That's what I think. I wouldn't say it makes us old. I would just say like older, because we're talking about 19-year-olds, yeah, okay, like fucking Kid Ken.
That's okay.
You know, they're young. You know what I mean?
But like, 7 Deep is amazing.
That's what I'm saying. And it's like, and to me, like, that would make sense, because like our music is like kind of harsh. It's kind of more turn up. But then it's also, we both dance, because he's pretty versatile, and so am I. Not, no homo.
Both homo, but I don't know. We're not gonna get it. Well, we could, but we're not.
I ain't getting in that chair. It's about the music. That's it.
Yes, about the music. I asked what's next. So what's next is, you would love to work with like 7D. What's up next? Like, are we getting another video? Do we have a single coming out?
You are getting a feature from Okay, so in order, it's gonna be my video is about to drop.
Okay.
So mine, like I said, like it's all night and mine are kind of going hand in hand. And so like if you watch like the all night video, you will see at the end it says to be continued. So it's like mine picks up from where all night left off, okay, to kind of show like how they're together. And I think the only thing I'll say about the mine video is that there's like a little bit of substance abuse in there. And so I got to play on that because I feel like everybody expects for the mine video to kind of be like this turn up kind of like, I don't know, raunchy type of song. Okay. But I really didn't go there. I went kind of left with it. So.
And when you say substance abuse, can we get a hint?
There's going to be drugs that were done.
Okay. Well, I think in 2021 we're okay with that. SZA just released a whole video with the number one song where the video is about her doing mushrooms. So
is it acceptable to everybody, or is it just a certain demographic?
Hell, Jesus, yeah, not even acceptable to everybody.
They ain't even accept Jesus when he died on the cross. But I think what I'm saying is, it's like, for example, like, right, not everybody is doing X pills, not everybody is doing coke. There are people who obviously
not doing that.
Yeah, there's obviously people who are, but I wouldn't say like it's socially acceptable where it's like, oh, okay, let me go pull this out in the middle of the video, right?
I was just at the club 2 days ago and somebody just pulled it out in front of me.
Okay, well, let me go ahead and do it right here, right now, because it's okay. Like, y'all not gonna like that, right?
Right.
But if I was to pull out some weed and roll up,
I'm like, let's go.
Yeah, baby. Y'all be like, oh yeah, we finna smoke on this video. And that's it. And so that's what I'm saying. And I'm not trying to make it socially acceptable or say it's not socially acceptable.
You just want
to
bring some awareness.
It's just, yeah, because I feel like that
is. A drug is a drug.
And that's it. And I feel like a lot of the times, right, when you're addicted to these drugs, that's why we have so much aggression and so much suicide and all these things, because like a lot of gays are trying to escape, you know, their harsh realities that they live. And so that's what I'm trying to bring. And so I know mine probably, like, again, like when you hear it, you don't think about shit like that. But the love between those two are actually toxic because, bitch, we were together that one night and you finna make this into a relationship. It started off kind of like in a negative, like, light.
Or it could be Cinderella. Cinderella had one night, and look at that bitch.
It very much could be one night. But this is not that situation. So, that is that.
Well, I can't wait to see the video. Mm-hmm. I can't wait to see who you collaborate with. I can't wait
Kodak
to see...
Kodak Ken is going to be my next collaboration. Cool. I'm going to just say that. Kodak Ken.
Okay.
Yeah, he from Alabama.
Okay.
Yeah, y'all gotta look that up. Kodak Ken.
Okay, Kodak Ken, y'all. We gon' Google him.
Yeah, Alabama. That's the South bitch right there. So.
Okay, yeah, so he told you what's got next. We can't wait. We gonna be watching. I thank you for coming.
Of course.
I really enjoyed this.
Of course. I enjoyed you too. I appreciate you coming.
But your little chocolate self, y'all ain't chocolate. He just chocolate. Look at him.
Am I though? I'm just kidding. No, I am. I'm probably like the same color as the shirt, but that's okay.
I am me.
I am. Me.
I am me.
I am me.
Don't care this thing we
do. I am me.
Oh, y'all face. Oh, I felt the fake.
When life comes calling, don't look back. When life comes calling, don't look
back. Okay, if you think I'm ready for this paper, let me say it like this. When your bitch ass starts here, to get your skinny motherfucking ass back out the goddamn way before I put my foot in your ass.
I dare you. He just hung up the phone. I'll break your neck.
Do you want a revolution? Woo, woo. Y'all, stop playing with Kurt. Stop playing with him. He's a parent. Y'all just saw that video. That was a parent. That was not an artist that sings gospel music. You know why that was a parent? Because a parent will cuss your ass out if you have to. My mama cussed me out. I don't love her less. I don't feel like it's abusive or toxic. Hell, my daddy do too. You know why? Because sometimes I do stuff that deserves to get cussed out about. And anybody saying that Kirk Franklin cussing out his son is toxic, I feel like you have a problem. You know why? Because you don't know what discipline is. A parent job is never done. A real parent tell you that. I'm 24. My mama still watching after me. And before her mother died, my mama was 40 and my grandma was 60. She still had her. Like, that's how it goes. So, I don't blame Kirk. Kirk, if you gotta cuss your son out until he understands, keep cussing him out, Kirk. But I hope y'all repair y'all relationship, because I'm all for father-son love. Whoop, 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 whoop. And I'm all for a family unit anyway. It's just sometimes you gotta get the bitterness out your heart. Yes, I do think his son was on some B-I-T-C-H type by doing this. Because, like, it wasn't that you didn't have to break it public for the attention. I hate the attention part of it. But if this is what it took for y'all to get past it, hey, I would love for them to get past it. Hey, whatever. And speaking of parents and screaming at you or whatever. This Easter Sunday, this Passover Sunday, April the 4th, all of them, because, you know, everybody called it different. The Isley Brothers versus Earth, Wind & Fire versus, baby, when I tell you I want a black jasmine candle and one of them big old chairs with the wood backs. You know, like, our parents got all the pictures in the old clubs. And I feel like somebody's supposed to have on some good pair of bell bottoms. Y'all know I wouldn't be a good pair. With a platform. Girl, this is the whole mood. This is like the revolution music. This was the R&B music that spoke to us during the Black Panther Party movement. I can't wait till they play Footsteps in the Dark. That is my favorite Isley Brothers song. Oh my God, it's so good. I keep hearing footsteps, baby. It's just, they don't make music like that no more. And then I don't know what I'ma do when Earth, Wind & Fire do Devotion. That is my, like, I don't know. Y'all know I have an old soul, so I have a knack. I have a knack for old R&B. And so I can't wait. It's going to be something for the culture. I'm really proud of Swiss and Timbaland. They have taken this Versus thing from, like, a small Instagram hour video to it being such a big thing. They sold it to Thriller, so now they don't own it anymore, but they are, what are they? Oh, they're both, the co-directors of the project. So they're both in charge still. They just don't own it. But they don't own all of it. They own a part of it. And all of the artists that did Versus before this just happened got a share. So they own some too. Because, you know, they didn't pay them. They just asked you, did you want to do it? So it's fun. That's fun. I love to see black money reciprocate. Like, because I had an idea and y'all liked it, y'all gonna pay for it. And then everybody else that I bought it get some too. Yes, pot. Let the pot grow. Let the pot grow. Speaking of pot and growing, on 420, Versus already announced that they're going to do another special, Red Man versus Method Man. Okay, so you know it's going to be smoke in the air, smoke in the air. I need you to have a good snack. Snacks, a meal. Yeah, just have a meal. Because it's 420, it's a national holiday. So you have to partake and enjoy yourself. I'm not a Red Man, Method Man fan. I can tell you any songs right off bat that by them that just get me. No. Method Man with Mary J. Blige, you all I need. You know, that's my shawty. Me and you, girl, believe me. Nothing makes. That's it. So, I feel like he wins just because he got a song with Queen Mary J. Blige, and I know it. So, hey. But, yep, that's on 420. I'm too excited about that. Also happening on 420, designer Left Handed D'Angelo, he's a designer here in Atlanta. He's having a fashion show. It's his birthday. He's going to be taking us through different seasons, all four seasons. He's tapped into Atlanta's stylist community and got some great underground stylists to help him. The show is going to be amazing. Tickets are for sale on his website. And I'm excited to see it. I'm excited because I'm part of it. And me working with somebody, I don't just work with anybody. So I know it's going to be together. So I hope you guys partake in those hot topics. Valentine's Day, I was feeling all lovey, right? I was here. Y'all got an episode. I was on cue. I was feeling it. Because I don't look for love. I let love come to me. And that's why I don't have it. But, it kind of saddened me that all these couples just broke up this week. Like, girl, what was going on? I know y'all used to keep me updated on whether it's a renegade moon or renegade sun or a false moon, a red moon, a black moon. Whatever, the moons, y'all be saying the moons be controlling everybody's emotions, so. But, Dream Dog and Bankroll Freddy, they broke up. I really liked them because I felt like they wasn't supposed to be together. Every time I saw them together, I was like, they weren't supposed to be together. But they made me believe it. So I was kind of sad. Like, they some hood rich shit. Like, so I was kind of sad they broke up. That was really sad. Then Quavo and Sweetie. Like, I liked their love because it was corny to me. Like, it was so corny to me. Like, that she was from the Bay. And he's from Atlanta. And he's a big rapper. And she makes music sometimes. And, like, I liked them because they were so corny. They were cute together. I hate they broke up, but it's understandable. Ain't nobody about to cheat on me. And if you do, I'm not going to still be with you. And that's just period. Okay? So, we're going to wish them the best of luck in their new endeavors of the single life. But the one that took me out the most is Gary Owens. I don't know if y'all know Gary Owens. Yeah, that's Gary Owens. Like, to me, yes, he's white, but he was like my uncle or something. Like, he knew about all black people stuff. He knew about kitchens. He knew about fried chicken. He knew what space was. Like, and it didn't seem like, appropriation. Like, it was like he made jokes. He was a comedian. And yes, most of his jokes was about being married to a black woman and having black kids. But the way he did it, especially in the time before how we sensitive right now, 2021 and 2020, he did it at a time where it was acceptable and we didn't shut him down. And so that's why I fell in love with Gary Owens. So it's kind of sad for me. I don't know his wife. I really don't know anything about her, but she's married to him. But it's sad for me to know they broke up. They've been married for 18 years. I would hate to hear of a marriage of 18 years to go down the toilet. They have 3 kids. All the kids are grown, so they don't have to worry about that aspect of it, I guess. But I'm kind of sad. That's really, really sad. Let's hope all these couples get back together. How about that? So, where the money reside. Have y'all got y'all stimmy? Y'all got y'all stimulus package? Have y'all hollered that big money bag jump? Have y'all? Girl, I ain't got mine yet. I know it's coming. It'll be here one day. But I'm gonna be just like all y'all. Then y'all done got y'all bad. Y'all getting stimulus packages. Y'all getting unemployment. Y'all taking y'all asses to work. Y'all getting tax money. Y'all got Rico around the corner paying your light bill. Y'all just, I'm not saying I'm jealous, but I'm just saying, I hope y'all praying. That's all I'm gonna say. But no. Y'all spend y'all money. Don't buy all the crab legs. Don't buy all the crab legs. I don't like them that much, but I want some to be there when I want one or two. Okay. What else? Girl, if you're going to buy that lace front, please make sure it's a good one. And don't let your cousin and them put it in. Let the right people put it in. Like, don't spend all that money. Sir, you do not have that much money. You don't have to pop bottles at the club. It's okay to give your baby mama some money for your child. Okay? I just want y'all to understand, like, all those things matter before you feel like you have to flex. So, like, yeah. Spend y'all money correctly. Do whatever y'all gotta do with it. Hell, slide a couple of dollars by Cash App. I don't know. But y'all enjoy y'all money. No cap. Enjoy it. Because guess what? When I get by, I will. I'ma act a goddamn fool. You know why? Because y'all motherfucking did. And that's on period.
What is going on, y'all? I'm Paige Alexander, aka CEO, and this is Trill Vibes, the podcast.
And I am Ish Baby.
And I'm sorry. And this is
Trill Vibes.
Yes, sir.
What's up? What's up? What's up? Let's get into it. Let's get into it. Let's get into it. Huh. So, my fashion must have, is gonna be these little shirts. The little Hawaiian vibe, the little Miami Vice vibe, the little silk. It's springtime, baby. I'm feeling cute. Why not? I feel like they look good. I feel like they're real versatile. I feel like anybody can pull one off, whether you big, fat, short, skinny, tall, all that. Anybody can pull these shirts off. Like, they just cute. Just wear the shirt. So, that's gonna be my fashion thing. So, get used to seeing me in a nice little silky, a little silk number. My listen worthy. Justin Bieber. He was very, very, very mad about the Grammy nominations. He felt like he should have been nominated more times in R&B categories. I can't blame him, because if he sees himself as an R&B artist, of course he feels like he should see himself in an R&B category. I'm not saying he's right or wrong. I'm just saying, if I see myself somewhere, I see myself somewhere. And that's on period. And my gag for this week. Y'all stay your ass at home. Do not stop. Don't book that flight. Don't fill that tank up. Do not take your ass to Miami. Don't do it. Girl, they had to shut the city down. They was open. The city was open for 3 days. 3 days. They had to shut it all the way back down. Y'all just out there showing y'all asses. And then y'all act like COVID ain't real. I'm vaccinated. So, hey. But that doesn't mean go around and just be all... That's like saying... Never mind, we're not gonna go there. But yeah, don't do that. Like, leave Miami alone. Let the folks enjoy their city. Come to Atlanta. We don't care. We ain't gonna never close down. Y'all can be here in the street twerking it. Y'all can be here burning down buildings. We still open. So... just leave Miami alone, please. Because I need Miami to be open for Rolling Loud in May. So, take your asses home. Spend your tax money right. Love on one another. Do a facial once a week. Drink water. Go to the gym. Don't buy that meal. Go home and cook something. All that. I'm just trying to be your voice in your head. And I will see you guys next time on The Gag. I'm Ty Valentino, and I'm out.